Maximum speed. Maximum strength.
Have you ever wanted to be invincible yet invisible with superhuman speed and superhuman strength?
Maximum strength.
Well, here's your chance via a well-known title released in 2007 called Crisis. Now, although I hate to pollute your mind with something as mundane as the plot, I think it's something that needs clarification because nobody seems to be able to explain it. Like, I asked several people what the storyline was prior to playing it, and I got a bunch of hogwash like, well, you see, Badger, you're kind of like Master Chief, but you're not, and you're fighting these Koreans that get overtaken by aliens, and then they try to nuke them, and it doesn't work, and none of this makes any sense. And as sad as it sounds, I sought salvation in a Wikipedia page featuring the synopsis, but even then, after playing the game, even that seemed erroneous.
Are you fucking retarded or something? That ain't fucking right.
In my view, the basic plot is that you're a super soldier that goes to the Philippines for the wrong reasons to meet some Koreans that don't want you there when you're surprised by aliens that are really extraterrestrial robot that have some kind of obsession with freezing things. And by things, I mean people in perfect breakdancing positions. Super suit. As expected, the suit that you'll be wearing throughout the game has some pretty nifty features that you already know about, but here's what they're really like beyond the official titles. Cloak. Although you get temporary invisibility, I like to call it the Jackson jacket because I can't help but hear that song in my head when I sneak up on people.
You've been hit by a smooth criminal.
Armor. This is your default setting where it seems like all you hear are ricochets because you're impervious to virtually all incoming bullets. Speed. I mean, you can go fast for like 4 seconds, then you're just sitting there wondering why you wasted so much energy on something so disappointing. It's like my average Friday night.
Oh, what the fuck?
Strength. Overall, pretty underwhelming. Like, for some reason, you jab like a 14-year-old girl, yet you can throw objects hundreds of meters in the air. And that's my main piece of advice when it comes to strength. Toss things around. Now, one last thing about the suit. All of these actions require energy, which depletes extremely quickly, yet also recharges quickly. So keep that in mind. And sadly, there is no option to take the suit off, meaning that you'll be wearing it throughout the entire course of the game. So no need to worry about losing it like Lucius from The Incredibles.
Where is my super suit?
Difficulty. Okay, the difficulty in this game is a little wonky because number one, it's not exactly easy on any setting because there's always 50 guys versus just you, but I found something peculiar that I did not understand. Like, the only major difference between the settings is that on easy, normal, and hard, the enemies speak English, but on the highest difficulty, which is Delta, they speak Korean. I'm sorry, but I what? On the first three difficulties, they speak English, but on the highest, they speak Korean, as if that's some kind of difficulty leap? I mean, I guess it would matter which Korea we're talking about here. Like, are we talking about overrated cuisine, I like to smear glitter all over my face and dance around in circles Korea? Or are we talking, I've forgotten what nutrients taste like, and my country's glorious leader dresses like an intern at a funeral home, Korea? I don't know, man. I mean, they share the same language, but I'm still puzzled as to how enemies speaking Korean somehow increases difficulty. I mean, it's not like the bullets care what language you speak, or gravity cares what language you speak. Hell, the carbon fiber wrapped around my technologically superior knuckles doesn't even care what language you speak.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Animals. I'm still impressed by the number of animals that Crytek managed to shove into this game. Even 8 years later, there are very few modern games that come close, with the exception of Far Cry, of course, but I'm surprised that PETA didn't throw a fit in 2007. Maybe it's just a casual inference of my own, but they're arranged in the game in such a way that they are just asking to get tossed around. Like, really? You're gonna shove a tortoise in front of me within the first 30 seconds in the game and expect me not to toss him around like a football with my superhuman strength? Come on now!
There it is! There it is!
And I'm not gonna explicitly say which animal is the most fun to toss around, but...
Look at all those chickens!
Knockoffs! Much like most electronics in the Western world, there are often cheap knockoffs produced in Asia, and this super high-tech nano suit is no exception. But even though they are Korean knockoffs, these guys are ridiculously tanky. Like, they take so much damage, even on normal difficulty, it's nothing short of laughable. Headshots. Extending the last point about being ridiculously tough, I can't express enough how important headshots are in this game, and allow me to show you why. Here's what your experience will be like firing for the torso. And here's what it will be like aiming for the noodle.
Headshot.
You see what I mean? So strap on a sniper scope and maximum strength, because it makes it much easier to hit enemies in the face. Vehicles. First of all, your commanding officer is extremely annoying while you're in a tank. If you get too aggressive, the Korean armor will tear you in half, but if you're even slightly too conservative, the major in charge of you will start teasing over the intercom.
You drive like a pussy!
The assault trucks are effective because you can fire the turret while driving on lower difficulties, but don't get too overzealous when driving at high speeds, because you can accidentally turn yourself into a bomb if you crash into things. And finally, the handling in the air vehicles is non-existent. I consider myself to be moderately effective with aircraft, and even I was miserable in the cockpit. Aliens. I like to think of these robotic alien enemies as gambling debts. They get progressively larger and larger. So don't think that just because you finished off one that you are somehow rid of the problem.
Without my help. Are you crazy?
Multiplayer. I honestly tried it for 5 minutes, and it was literally just myself and one other guy in Arkansas that questioned my sexual orientation because I didn't want to challenge him in Guitar Hero.
So yeah, you're gay.
And that's about it.